say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the
Dr. Arrington, Colonel Blanco, Colonel Manning, Dr. Bailey, Command Sergeant Major Blue, distinguished guests, parents, staff, family, and friends, thank you for spending this special time with the class of 2021. It is truly an honor to be the principal of Daegu Middle High School and serve the Area 4 community. Military members, thank you for your service and your commitment to our country. I want to personally thank Colonel Manning for his comments. We appreciate the time and effort you and your wife have shown for the students and staff at Daegu Middle High School. Thank you. I would also like to thank Dr. Arrington and Dr. Bailey for their commitment, vision, and leadership for the future of PacWest District. Thank you. To our parents, this year has been a year first. We moved from remote learning to face-to-face learning several times and back again. I know it was not easy. Thank you for keeping your children focused on the prize of graduation and their next steps. Good luck, and thank you for your continued support during your time here in Daegu. You will be missed. I want to thank my staff for their hard work this year. We had great challenges before us this year delivering instruction, and I can't thank you enough for your efforts. You were up for the challenge. Continue keeping our students the focus of your teaching. For the class of 2021, I want to first thank you for supporting your parents. I can only imagine the sacrifices many of you have made to support your parents in the service to this great country. Thank you.
Congratulations, class of 2021. I'm Tom Brady, the director of DODEA. This past year has been unlike any other in DODEA history. I know it was not what you imagined or hoped for your senior year of high school. But let me tell you what I saw this year. I saw DODEA students around the world demonstrating resilience and adaptability when presented with challenges of transitioning between in-person and remote and virtual learning and back and forth. I saw you wearing masks, being socially distant to protect the health and safety of others and those around you. You made sacrifices for the good of others and the protection of those most at risk. I saw you caring for each other and maintaining meaningful connections, whether it was in person or online, to bring comfort and encouragement during these tough times. I am so proud of you. This year, you displayed compassion, flexibility, and just plain grit. You rolled with the punches, overcame obstacles, and focused on what was most important: family, community, education, and your fellow students. I am now more sure than ever that you will succeed in your future endeavors and that each of you will continue to make the world a better place through your actions. On behalf of your teachers, your principals, and all of us at DODEA, congratulations, graduates.
Hello, DODEA graduating class of 2021, family members, staff, and distinguished guests. It's so nice to be able to join you all virtually today as we celebrate the graduating class of 2021. Our graduates have overcome significant challenges due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Their school experience certainly looked different this year, with numerous mitigation strategies in place to support a safe and healthy learning environment, and limited opportunities to participate in in-person athletic and extracurricular events. As I was thinking about this and the exceptional circumstances surrounding this year's virtual graduation, this quote from Maya Angelou came to mind. "I can be changed by what happens to me, but I refuse to be reduced by it." Graduates, as you enter this next chapter in your lives, understand that while you cannot control the events that happen to you, you can control how you respond. Respond with your heart. Respond with your mind. Respond with your voice. COVID-19 undoubtedly altered what you envisioned your senior year would look like, but in the face of this pandemic, you have exemplified what it means to be resilient when facing adversity. You, as a senior class, you have a unique shared experience that will bind you together for a lifetime. The class of 2021 will be remembered for graduating amidst the COVID-19 pandemic, but this does not overshadow your accomplishment. You put in the work and you earned this moment. Let's celebrate it together. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Hello, my name is Jeff Arrington, and I am the superintendent for the Dodea Pacific West District. That includes South Korea and Guam. I want to take this opportunity to share just a few thoughts with you as graduates for school year 2021. You have been through a lot of things that most people won't be from this pandemic, your resilience, but I want to share just a quick message with you. Remember how you took on this opportunity, I'll say, to succeed through these trying times, how you identified what you need to do, whether that be with remote learning and work at home, to overcome the challenges with technology or with teachers and technology or schools and technology, or that be the mitigation measures when you came back to school and how to be successful with all those barriers in your way and where to put them in between classes or carrying them around throughout the day, wearing masks, being separated from your friends. But through that, all of those challenges, you were able to succeed. You were able to overcome. And now because of that, you have success. And I want you to take that with you, to think about everything that comes before you in your life. If you can break it down into what you need to do, to accept it as a challenge and an opportunity and find ways to overcome, you will succeed. Please take that message with you in your life, put it into practice, because I know you'll do great things. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Good evening. It is my pleasure to welcome students, families, teachers, and special guests Colonel Manning and Dr. Arrington to the graduation day at Daegu Middle High School for the class of 2021. Every one of you has had an influence on the graduates who sit here today. Without a doubt, this year has not been an easy one. Despite college applications, scholarship essays, exams, and COVID, we finally reached the finish line. This year was our chance to prove our resilience, and that is exactly what we did. We went back and forth from virtual learning to in-person learning. We carried our barriers through the hallways every single day and came to school every morning not knowing if we would go back to HBCon Charlie the next day. This year was not only about learning derivative rules, history, or how to write an argumentative essay. We learned how to adapt to the ever-changing nature of life. We learned time management and scheduling while we were in remote learning. We did not only wake up in the morning to attend 40-minute classes over Google Meets, we had to plan our entire days accordingly in order to turn in assignments on time. Every day we accepted the fact that we will be doing this for the foreseeable future. The key to success is accepting difficulties. No matter where we go or what we do, there will always be challenges ahead of us. This is inevitable, but being defeated is optional. It is my greatest hope that our demonstrated resilience will carry on with us as we head into the real world. What I'm asking from each of you and from myself is to face those challenges straight on with your head held high. It is not enough to simply try to get by in life. Strive for excellence in everything you do and remember the challenges you have faced to get where you are. Thank you, class of 2021.
First, I would like to thank everyone here tonight in support of the class of 2021 as we take our next steps into the world. We could not have gotten this far without the support of our friends, families, and many of the staff here at Daegu Middle High School. Again, thank you everyone for all that you have done in our lives and believing in our capabilities and future. When I thought about what a student council president's speech should be, I decided to write a letter to each of you. You will find it on your seat and you can open it after graduation. Even if we weren't that close or our encounters were simply a quick conversation in the hallway, you made a difference to me and this school, and you will always matter. In our futures, we will all inevitably change. 10 years from now, none of us will be the same person that is sitting here tonight. We will all hold new experiences, greater knowledge, and each and every one of us will have faced challenges that will have made us stronger. But here, in this room tonight, we are all taking our first step into our lives together, leaving behind the security within these four high school walls and stepping into the real world. Everything will change. We will enter a world full of differences, new movements, change, fear, and uncertainty. But the best thing that we can do stepping into our future is to take every challenge and opportunity as it comes towards us, putting our best foot forward and taking on everything as best we can, standing by our beliefs and staying true to ourselves. Don't let anything stop you from taking on challenges and enjoying the moments in your life, because once a moment has passed, there is no going back. There was a quote I once heard that stated, "There are no 7 wonders of the world in the eyes of a child. There are 7 million. Children step into their lives full of fearlessness, hope, wonder, unimaginable dreams, and a kind of light that inspires even the ugliest things in this world to become beautiful. So my wish for all of you is that you will lead your life with this kind of inspiration and light, facing the world with no fear and only hope. You can do anything you set your mind to. You are your biggest enemy and yet your biggest inspiration. So in these years, find yourself and continue to enjoy your life. Thank you, class of 2021, for sharing these high school years with me. We will all make this world a beautiful place because we are all perfectly imperfect in this world. I've learned so much from all of you, and I hope that all of your biggest dreams will one day come true. The world is sitting at your fingertips, and all you have to do is take it. Thank you."
The class of 2021 would like to introduce the valedictorian and salutatorian finalists for Daegu Middle High School. These students represent the highest academic achievement received through advanced and rigorous coursework while maintaining the highest GPAs. At this time, I would like to introduce Lisa Lyons and Lois Wong.
Hello, welcome to the Daegu Middle High School's class of 2021 graduation. I'm Lois Wong and I have been in Daegu for less than a year. Before we begin, on behalf of the senior class, I would like to thank everyone watching from home or live, parents, teachers, family, and friends. We are so happy that you are here with us to celebrate this important milestone. Next, I would like to give credit to everyone who have made it possible for me to be here today. Of course, I give all my glory to God. Every success, every aspect of my life is because of Him and His undying love for me. Without Him, I am nothing. So I thank my Heavenly Father. Next, I would like to thank my family, the Huangs. I know I was a handful, but thank you for always supporting me, always being there for me, and always pushing me to greater heights. I know I say it all the time, and it's probably become trite, but I love you, Mom and Dad. And David, you're a good brother too. I love you. Next, I would like to thank my friends for always keeping me accountable for my academic life and for always telling me that I don't sleep enough. Thank you, Abby and Trinise, for always spilling tea and making my senior year worthwhile. Finally, I thank all my teachers who have encouraged me and taught me throughout the years. Even the ones that don't remember my name or the ones that who said I wasn't smart enough for the gifted program in elementary school, but I thank you. I thank all my teachers at Daegu Middle High School, especially Miss Audie, Miss Fisher, Miss Emery, and Mr. Lucas. You have made my short time in Daegu a memorable one. Now to the senior class of 2021. Congratulations, we did it. We are finally at the end of our legal obligation to go to school. Some of us may have enjoyed it and some of us have hated it, but we have all successfully arrived at its end. Soon, we will be officially transitioning from high school students to high school graduates. And it's truly a crazy time to be alive. When I envisioned the year 2021, around this time last year, truthfully, I could not. I tried to imagine a bright and unforgettable future, making new friends and new memories, celebrating our 18th birthdays, and traveling throughout South Korea, but I could not. When I tried to picture myself receiving the diploma that signified the end of my childhood, I could not. From the beginning, the year 2021 has been a challenge for us all. Internally, our nation has been full of turmoil, and our entire world seems to be in crisis. As an Asian American, seeing my country's failure to protect its people has filled me with grief and anger. However, if the world's chaotic events have taught us anything, it is that the future is hard to predict. Life is strange, and so are the various obstacles that stumble into our lives. Many of us wander our whole lives searching for our quote-unquote purpose. We do not know what the future holds, and yes, it is frightening. But really, the future is something we can depend on. Because no matter what happens, the future will be different from the present. The conditions of our world, of our country and its people, and even our personal lives are guaranteed to change. But we have the ability to drive and direct that change. In the words of Dr. Seuss, only you can control your future. With this hope, we can create and look forward to a kinder fate for ourselves and for others. It means that we can change lives for the better, including our own. Now, as you all embark on a new chapter in your lives, you have the opportunity to take on the world and make your mark, to depend on a future in which you positively inspire the lives of others, to leave them with a little more joy and hope. I want to emphasize that our time here together will not be remembered by grades, popularity, likes, or favorites, but by our relationships, the way we treated each other. So as the minutes turn into hours, hours turn into days, and days turn into years, I urge you to try new things, meet new people, and challenge yourself always, because we often regret things we do not do than the things we do. So as we are young, we think there is time to spare, but what this year has taught us is that these coming years will go faster and faster until we reach the end. In a split second, it will be over. So what I want to say to you, and especially to myself today, is treasure every minute and every relationship as if it were the most valuable things in the world. Because really, it is. I believe that you and I will change the world in a good way, even if that's just one person's world. Thank you. Congratulations, class of 2021. Woo!
Hello. It is a privilege and honor to be welcoming our friends, family, teachers, administrators, special guests, and of course the graduating class of 2021. I think I can safely speak on behalf of my classmates when I say thank you for joining us on this momentous occasion. This ceremony is both a celebration of what we have accomplished and a challenge for us to strive for even greater heights. First, I would like to start off by thanking God for giving me the strength and courage to press on both academically and spiritually through my high school years, and especially in times of discouragement. Then, a special thank you to my mom and dad, who've instilled me with a strong passion for learning and for doing everything possible to put me on a path to greatness. I wouldn't have made it so far without your unwavering support and dedication. I know it is an understatement to say that at times it was extremely hard to raise me, but you did it. I love you both very much. Administration and teachers, thank you for your enormous contribution and guidance on our upcoming journey to adulthood. Thank you for your knowledge, care, support, and eternal incentives. Thank you for believing in us and always pushing us to be the best that we can be. And most importantly, thank you for the patience and lessons that you have taught us. After that, to Ms. Imri, our senior class sponsor, we are grateful for the love that you have shown our class, for taking so much of your own time and resources to fight and support our class, to have a voice and as many opportunities as we could. Your hard work is not overlooked, and each one of us appreciate you. And last but not least, the parents and guardians of the senior class. We will treasure and be forever indebted to you for the support, sacrifice, and unconditional love that you have given us throughout our lives. When I first sat down to write this speech, so many thoughts were flowing through my mind. To be quite honest, I was overwhelmed by what exactly it is that I want to share with you all today. Am I going to reminisce about the memories of great importance to me? Talk about significant events to the entire school? I thought, is there a message that I should try to convey? After a good couple weeks pondering and putting off writing this speech, as I did for the past 4 years for all of my assignments, I've come to conclude that I want to talk about what defines us as the DMHS graduating class of 2021. If all of you look at our graduating class today, we are all military-connected students. Every single one of us, not only because we are residing in Korea, were raised in a culture other than that of our parents or the culture of our country of nationality. We have all lived in a multitude of different environments during a significant part of our childhood years, and maybe our entire lives. Some of us have been all around the world, PCS every couple of years, have constantly had to make new friends, go to a new school every couple of years, and repeatedly rebuild a new foundation at a new duty station. Others are the ones that stayed behind in one place, building a well-established life, almost to a point where it is the only home they've ever known. Because being a cross-cultural kid is such a large part of our identities, there are many things in our daily lives that we consider such a norm that others may consider unusual. Growing up, it is without a doubt that you probably have both loved and despised this lifestyle and the circumstances that you have been put in because of it. Ranging from the constant questioning of North or South, wait, where are you from? Or even, you still don't have your license? Many of us have often struggled to blend in and answer some of the most simple questions that our peers could answer in the blink of an eye. In truth, it really doesn't matter. We are all kids that belong to many different countries and have multiple homes. Because we are military-connected students, we've developed a mindset of which is exceptionally tolerant and understanding of others. We are open-minded, possess exceptional skills in different languages, and are often very sensitive to other people and their cultures. Often, we forget to look past the opportunities we've been given and only look at the negatives. I hope that by now, we've all come to realize the values of this unique time in our lives while living abroad and not take for granted all of the memories we've built in the first 18 years of our lives. Writing this speech gave me the opportunity to think and reflect on what high school teaches us outside of the formal curriculum. What everyday knowledge or informal experiences that we have acquired throughout the past 4 years that has helped us and will continue to help us in the future. By this, I don't mean the trivial and cliche issues arising from the drama or the inevitable fallouts that we have all experienced, but more so about the valuable life lessons that we have learned through times of joy, distress, and hardship. We've learned the need for patience, to withstand adversity, to stay strong in what we believe in, and to stay true to our virtues rather than the expectations of others. To quote J.K. Simmons, the aha moment is the first time you gain an insight about yourself or the world around you. The uh-oh memories are where you ask yourself, what have I done now? The uh-oh moments are worth cherishing just as much as the aha moments. Mistakes, failures, embarrassments, and disappointments are a necessary component of growing wise. We can learn more from our not-so-good experiences than we can learn from our good ones. I've learned that learning and choosing to improve yourself does not end after high school. No matter what chapter of your life that you choose to write next, you will never stop learning and improving. It will always be one's own responsibility to live up to their true potential, have faith in themselves, and persevere in order to manifest their own aspirations. Our life is not defined by our high school grades or how many extracurricular activities that we have participated in. We can all be successful, but that success will look different. You need to value your own success instead of comparing yourself to everyone else. That, as Eleanor Roosevelt had once said, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Now, in light of ongoing events, I would like to share with you some of the socially unjust challenges that many Asian Americans face while growing up. Asian Americans are frequently perceived as a model minority, which encompasses a stereotype portrayal of hard work and success. The current stereotype of Asian Americans is that they are smart, competent, and hardworking. Because this association is a positive model minority stereotype, many view it as benign or less worthy of scrutiny compared with the negative characterizations surrounded by ethnic discrimination. However, simply because a stereotype involves a conceivably favorable stereotype or characteristic does not guarantee that it will be received as a compliment by the stereotype community. All such stereotypes do to people, including many Asian American youth as myself, is discredit the personal determination and hard work that one puts in to earn their achievements. Microaggressions are common, and comments such as, you're Asian, you're supposed to be smart, can be very detrimental to the development of an adolescent youth. Adding to this, I would like to shed light on the discrimination and social injustices that Asian people are now facing in our society. Asian American communities over the past year have experienced fear and stigma from what appears to be a wave of harassment and hate violence. During the first 6 months of the pandemic alone, the Coalition Stop AAPL Hate lodged over 2,500 anti-Asian hate incidents across the nation, including verbal harassment and physical assaults. The Center of the Study of Hate and Extremism at California State University, San Bernardino, reports that anti-Asian hate crimes in 2020 in the 16 of the largest U.S. cities, as reported to police departments, surge up to 149% of the previous annual total. Why do I mention all of this at a high school commencement ceremony? Around 40% of our graduating class are Asian Americans. Around 85% of our graduation class are part of a minority group. At least 70% of the students at our high school are part of a minority group. And our school is located overseas in an Asian country. Quoting Kamala Kenney, our class of 2020 valedictorian, in these unprecedented and unsettling times of the COVID-19 outbreak and the recent protests against inequalities and injustice, our country is faced with some stark contrasts and important choices in the days ahead. This has provoked reflection and conversations in many households across America. In other households, there are those who choose not to reflect or hold conversations about inequality and injustice. I feel that it is important for our class to be aware of what is going on in our country today, and that the first step that we as individuals can take to lead our country and society into the right direction is to acknowledge the issue. There are moments in world history where social justice issues come to the forefront of global consciousness, and this right now is such a time. The coronavirus pandemic has uncovered and exacerbated social inequalities, and I would like to encourage everyone to stand up for what is right and help solve the centuries-long inequalities and injustices for the Asians, Blacks, Hispanics, and other disadvantaged groups. Although we are young, our voices are powerful, and it is time for us to take responsibility for what happens in our country. It is time to hold each other accountable, to take actions towards change and towards justice. I would like to conclude my speech with a quote from Robert Frost. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the road less traveled by, and that had made all the difference. I encourage you, the class of 2021, to not only follow the opportunities available to you, but to follow your heart and pursue a cause of particular importance to you. Instead of following the path of past generations and graduating classes, I challenge you all to make your own path. The risks are always present, but the battle always makes the win so much sweeter. I wish you all the best and hope that you all never stop reaching for your dreams. Goodbye and congratulations, class of 2021, and thank you.
I am very proud of the plans and the goals that the graduating class of 2021 has set for themselves. If their high school career is any indication of what they can accomplish, the ceiling has no limits. Today, we will graduate 28 seniors. We graduated one senior in January and a second in May, and we will graduate the other 28 today. The class has currently been awarded $1,527,424 to support their college efforts, and the amount continues to grow. For the class of 2021, I wish you all my best. If you can't change the world, make an impact. A place should be better because you were there. You have heard about the money of this class has received, and it continues to grow. When the class of 2021 exits this hall, they will scatter to all parts of the United States and the world, from California to Washington, D.C., from Hawaii to Texas. In a few short weeks, the class of 2021 will begin to leave their legacy. Their future is their own. They will take their first step today. To the class of 2021, don't look back. It is all there for the taking. Find a partner, a passion, have fun, make your mark. Yes, Lexi, Bethany, Alyssa, and DeAndre, because you asked, I have placed a $2 bill under your diploma as a challenge for the graduates. Yes, $2. I am doubling down on the class of 2021. Each one of you has so much potential. By itself, $2 alone cannot accomplish much. But with some hard work, some friends, and some help, the possibilities are endless. That $2 bill could help find a cure for cancer, launch a million-dollar empire, start a nonprofit, or feed you during hard times. Choose wisely the way you spend your money and your time. On behalf of the Department of Defense Education Activity and its director, Mr. Thomas Brady, the Department of Defense Education Activity Pacific and its director, Ms. Lois Rapp, along with the Pacific West District and its superintendent, Dr. Jeff Arrington, as principal, I certify that these seniors have met all the requirements set forth for graduation. By the authority vested in me by the Department of Defense Education Activity, I confer onto you the title of Graduates of Daegu Middle High School. Please move your tassels.
Lexi Marie Berry.
I just want to say thank you to my mom and my dad and my little brother. I would not be here without you guys, and I love you. And thank you to everyone else who's been a part of my journey. I did it.
Dawn Breyer.
Thank y'all, especially Miss Emery, for such an amazing year.
Alyssa Jasmine Klein.
Thank you to everyone who supported me so far, and I appreciate all of the love and support.
Ella Marie Cooley.
I can't believe I'm finally graduating this year. I'd like to thank my parents for pushing me through the end of the school year and never giving up on me. I'm glad to have you guys in my corner.
Logan Allen Ferguson.
It took me 4 years to graduate, but here I am. Couldn't have done it without you, Mom, Dad, Gracie.
Tia Frazier.
Thank you for being the best family that you could be. I couldn't have asked for anything more.
Ethan Garrett Gomez.
Mom and Dad for always pushing me to do my best. I love you both.
Avanette
Hinton. I just want to say thank you to my mom and dad for all their love and support, and thank you to all my friends. Love you guys.
Lois
Jiwon
Huang.
Hi mom, hi dad. Thank you for everything you've done for me. I love you so much, and love you, Chinese and Abby too.
Curtis Kissed.
Hi, Mom and Bryson. Thank you for everything you've done to get me where I am now, and I love you.
Lisa Song Lyons.
Thank you to everyone who's helped and supported me.
Marin Natasha McGrath.
Thank you so much to everyone who has been supporting me to the end of the year that allowed me to pursue my future.
Joseph Edmund Moreno.
Mom, Dad, sister, myself, thank you. I won't let you down.
Hansel Don Morris.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for dealing with me throughout these years. I love you both.
Andrew Nellums III.
I want to thank the staff for giving me this experience in Daegu Middle High School, and I want to thank my parents for helping me going through this.
Bethany McKenzie Newbold.
I just want to say thank you to my family and my parents for always showing me unconditional love and support throughout my years of high school and life. I did it.
DeAndre Jarrell Audi.
I would like to thank my family and friends who have gotten me throughout this school year, and I would also especially like to thank my parents, Andrew and Stephanie Audi. Y'all are the best.
Trenise Ledesma Poggio.
First, I want to thank God, and I want to thank my family and friends for all their support and love. I love you guys.
Kyungbin Park.
Hello, everyone. This is Kevin, and I just want to thank everyone who supported me throughout this whole entire high school for 4 years. I really appreciate you guys. Thank you for all the support and love.
Min Park.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. Thank you so much for your support throughout the years. Thank you. I love you.
Brianna Lynn Peden. Albany Pryor.
Thank you for everything. I'm so excited to graduate.
Andrew Connor Reeves.
Hi, family and friends. Thank you so much for all you've done for me. I really appreciate it all.
Sean Joseph Rios.
Hey, Mom. Hey, Dad. I just want to say thank you for taking care of me all these years, even if I wasn't, you know, the best the whole time. Love you.
Lillian Gage Sanchez.
I just want to say thank you to my mom and dad and my brother and sister and all of my teachers that have helped me throughout high school.
Victoria Sergi.
I just want to say thank you to my family and my friends for support and to all of you who believed in me. I did it. I'm in Hawaii now. Don't listen to the haters.
Daniel Alem Sowers.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for everything. Cesar Chocsevier.
Madison Nicole Thomas.
I'd like to thank my family and friends for encouraging me throughout this year. I wouldn't be here without you guys. Love you.
Mario Tringali. Donna Smith. Johan Kyle Obian.
I'm Kyle. Mom, Dad, thank you. And thank you to myself.